Hi, good morning and welcome to Live with Joy. I'm going to give it a few moments for everybody to come on and find that post, and then we're going to get started with what we are going to be doing today and what we have been doing for this week. So as we wait for everybody to come on, let's just kind of go over what we have been doing. We worked some balance this week. We made sure we got our upper body strength. We hit our cardio and core. We had a full body mix on Monday. And today we are finishing out with our lower body. So today is going to be about lower body strength, but it's going to be in a very activated way, just like we did upper body on Wednesday. So we are going to use our weights and our body to have continuous movement with a lot of reps today. So if you wanna go a little bit lighter with those legs, you can, or you can go a little bit heavier since legs are stronger. But there will be some arm movement that's gonna go along with some of those moves. So you might just want to make sure that you're mindful of what the upper body can do to move those weights through that lower body movement that we're gonna be doing in some of those circuits. In others, we're just gonna be holding the weight steady, but of course, you'll still have to use your upper body to hold it in place as you go through the lower body movement. But there will be a lot of reps today, so if you wanted to do no weights at all and just use your own body weight, that would be fine, and you would still get a great workout out of this today, and you would still work that lower body strength and hit it pretty hard, okay? So just keep that in mind. A lot of reps today, just like we did the other day. We're gonna use the same sequencing where we start with one exercise, we add another one, we go back to the second exercise only, and then we add back that first exercise again, and we kind of combo it out a little bit, okay? So same idea that we're gonna be doing today, all right? What you're gonna need is your dumbbells if you are gonna use weights. We're gonna also use a mat today. We're gonna take it down for the last two circuits to hit the lower body from the floor, okay? So that won't be until that final circuit where we kind of incorporate two different exercises, okay? So make sure that you've got that mat handy and make sure that you have your weights, okay? With that said, I'm gonna start the music. We're gonna warm up. So my timer's over here today, so you'll kind of see me walk back and forth just to kind of get that timer started since I have everything hooked up to the stereo. So we're just gonna get that music going. All right, guys, get those shoulders down, track back, and reach that center. Let's march it out, right, left, standing up nice and tall. Two more sets, just that march. Keep it there. Just gonna make it a little louder. Keep marching with that narrow march for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Take those legs out wide, wide march. Eight more. Let's go 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. March it back in. 8, 6, 4, 3, 2. Take those legs out wide. Wide march. 4, 3, 2. March it back in. 4, 3, 2. Let's take it wide. 4, 3, 2. March it in. 4, 3, 2. Take it wide. 4, 3. Hold it wide and squat it. Bend the knees and bend the elbows. Push that bottom back. Keep that chest open. And sit it down and up. You've got 4 more. Then we slow it up. Down 2, up 2. In 2 more. Now down 2, up for 2. Take it down. For 2 and up. 3 more times. Down. And up, 2 more times, down, for 2, and up, 1 more time, down, pick up your speed, 4, 8, 7, from here, we're going to step it back, right, left, and reach it overhead, you've got 4 more, 3, 2, now step it back, right and left, reach as you step, either tap back, or take a big step and a big bend. Those knees, reach as you take it back. 8 more times right here. 8. Then back to that wide squat as you interlock those fingers behind that head or loosely behind those ears. 1 more on each side. Now take it wide and interlock. Bend and extend at the same time. Open the chest, squeeze and retract the back. Sit it down and up. 4 more. Press up. 3 more. watch it. 5, 4, 3, 2, march it in for 8, 4, 3, 2, take it 5, 4, 3, 2, march it in, 4, 3, 2, take it 5, 4, 3, 2, march it in, 4, 3, 2, take it wide and hold, legs out, hands on the thighs, and hinge forward with a nice flat back and hold, then round it up, stretch that spine, take a moment right there, then flat back down, and hold all the way up, allow that head to come up last, and roll those shoulders back. Alright, so watch me for your first two exercises, and then we're going to have another two exercises that we're going to incorporate with 10 seconds in between as we get ready. Right? First exercise, we're going to be hinging forward. Now when we add on here, we're going to go into front squat, so the weights come up and we squat down. So you've got to move those weights as you do one of each. Now you'll just hold those front squats. If for any reason you don't want to put the weights on the shoulders, you can do your squat from here with the weights to the side, front hinge, okay? And then we're going to be getting rid of one weight, taking a staggered stance, and watch my back foot. We're coming up onto the back toe and pressing it down. First exercise, nice and easy. And then we're going to hold it up and add a split squat to that, press that heel down. So every time that we come up onto the ball of the foot, that's when we bend to that split squat, okay? And then we'll move through that and we'll alternate back, okay? First thing that you need to worry about is that hinge forward. So get your weights, shoulders down and back, engage your center. We're going to keep those legs straight with a slight bend in the knees. Nice flat back as we hinge forward up for 30 seconds. Then we'll add that front squat in. So now you are on the clock. At the moment, 30 seconds, just those hinges, okay? So right here, 30 seconds, now at 20, and then we're going to add that front squat in, or take the weights to the side, make it just a squat without bringing the weights up, up if you can. So again, you're going to move to that upper body a little bit. Make sure you have weights that you control to move those weights with the upper body as you work through the lower. Good, so watch me. We're gonna hinge forward, get the weights up on the shoulders, sink into that squat, lower down, and hinge. So you gotta move those weights a little bit to get both of those moves in. Now we're gonna go to just that front squat, keeping the weights on the shoulders if you can. If not, just hang it down to the side. If you don't wanna move those weights with the upper body, that's okay. We're not focusing on the upper body today, but you are gonna need a little upper body strength to move through it. All right, now we're staying right here, weights to your side if you wanna bring them up here, and just that one squat, and then we'll finish up by adding back in that hinge to the front squat with one of each. 20 seconds, focusing on just that front squat. That last one in, and then we're going to add that back hinge. Weights come down, weights come up, and we squat. So here we're hinging through the hips, here we are bending through the knees. One of each. One in, get your one weight on the floor, hold on to one, okay, so you can really focus on what the lower body's doing. Get that leg wide, so left foot's forward, right foot is back. Lift up onto the back heel, lift on, onto the back toes rise, so the heel is coming up, and then you're pressing down. Think about using that calf muscle to lift up onto the ball of the foot, and then you're going to be in position, that split squat, from the ball of that foot. That front foot just staying flat. That nice lengthening, lift up onto the ball of the foot, and get that contraction in that calf. Good. And then we're going to be adding on. So once you're on the ball of the foot, bend both knees. Think about bending the back knee. Take that back knee as close to the floor as you can, and that front knee will naturally follow. And down. And then in that second set, we're going to be changing the lead leg that's in front, right? And the one that get that last one in. And now we're staying right here in that split squat. You want to be staying on the ball, that foot back. So see how my heel is up? You want to be up. Good. Feel that back leg super contracted through the calf, the shin, the quad, as you bend and extend through it. And then we're going to add back in that heel down, coming up in 5 more seconds. So get ready. Let's combo it out. Get that split squat in. Rest that heel down when you're up. Lift to the ball of the foot. And lower down. Good. Keep it nice and controlled. Good. Press and lengthen. Lift. Now you're in position to come down to that split squat. Readjust at any point if you need to. Take that moment to readjust and then come back to it. Finish out. And now grab that other weight. Going back to those hinges with that front squat combo. Right here, shoulders down and back. Starting with just that hinge. That nice flat back. Keep that chin off of that chest. Feel that nice lengthening through the back of those legs. One in, and now when you come up, weights on the shoulders if you can, at the side if you don't want to move through those weights so much in the upper body. Here if you can, really close that nice strong squat that just lifted. And you're going to get a little bit of upper body work as well. Hinge forward, but our focus is in the lower body, so think about the movement through your body. Good. We're going to stay here in that front squat. Weights at your side. You're going to hold them up on your shoulders. Elbows up in front of you. If you got those weights up. And then we're going to add back that hinge. And then go to the other side for that calf raise in that staggered stance. Get ready, and back in. Once you come up in that front squat, into that hinge, and one front squat. Good, don't bend until the weights are in position. Don't hinge until the weights are in position. So move through it, and then move your body down. Good. Finish up that last one. Get rid of one of those weights. You're now going to have that right foot forward and that left foot back in your staggered stance. Find your position. Lift up onto the ball of the foot and then press that heel down and into the floor. Okay, so this is going to start to get us into that position where we are ready for that split squat when we're up on the ball of that foot. So you got to work on this position first before you add on that split squat. Make sure you're in proper form right here at the top of that move. That's where you want that next move to come from. Good. So once you're on the ball of the foot, you're adding on, adjust the knee to make it a bigger stance or a smaller stance based on how you feel in that split squat. Press the heel down, lift it up, and lower. And lower to wherever you feel comfortable. It could be a tiny little bend or it could be all the way to the ground if you wanted to, but with control and cushion underneath that knee if you're going to place that knee on the floor. Good. All right, we're going to focus on just that split squat right here. Pressing up, front foot, flat. Back foot, you're staying on the ball of those toes. From that staggered stance right here. Once you come up from that split squat, press the heel down, come on up, readjust those feet if you need to. Even those shins at work right here. Ankle strength and stability. Knee strength and stability. And come on up. Good. All right. Watch me from your next set of exercises. Get a little bit of water. All right. We are going to start with those feet together now. Okay. Or as close as you can get them, weights right to your side. This is going to be your chair squat. Kind of squeezing those knees together. From here, we're going to add on a step out into a wide squat. We're going to move through the weight. So watch here. We start with just the right side. So it will be your chair squat, step into your wide squat, into your chair squat, and we're going to keep it all on that right side coming out and in. Then just your wide squat and adding back in. Then we will lose again one of those weights. We're going to do right side only, standing hip abduction, and then we're going to add on side lunge to that, and then just the side lunge. Now, if side lunge is too much, we're just stepping, and then that hip abduction, stepping side, and then that hip abduction, okay? First thing you're going to do is get those feet together as close as you can, and we're going to sit down and up in that chair squat. Resetting that clock now, so get into your position. Get set, listen to my voice, and go. You are on the clock for 30 seconds. Good morning, everybody. I hope you are waking up the lower body right now. Feet together, or again, as close as you can get them. Try to squeeze those knees together if you can. And when we have that, step out into that wide squat movement. Again, it's gonna all go to the right for our first set. Everything's gonna be on the right side. Then we'll shift it over to the left on our second set. Good, get ready to move through those weights a little bit. So get one close, step, get the weights out of the way, go into that wide squat and bring it in, weights come down. So you wanna step and squat, get the weights out of the way, bring it back to the side, then you can come down. Good, nice and into that nice wide squat as you take it out and in. And now you're gonna hold that wide squat, so you're gonna stay here. You want those feet to be a little bit more than shoulder width apart in that wide squat. And then we'll add back in that chair squat for that final sequence to finish it out. Staying in just that wide squat right here. Getting that wide squat, stepping in, weights come to the side, close together, step wide and squat, come in together, and take it down. And yes, we are moving the upper body a little bit with some of those circuits today to get those weights in position where they need to be. All right, let's get rid of one of those weights and just hold on to it in front of the body. Ground your left leg, and we're going to take that right leg out and in for that hip abduction right here. And then we're going to add in a side lunge or just a side step out and in without that bend, okay? So again, you decide where you want to be with a side lunge or with that just step out and step back in. We're going to start with one of each. One of those hip abductions and one of those side lunges. So it's going to look like this. Out when you come in, and you have to step into that side lunge. Once you're up, out and in. Now again, if you're not going into the side lunge, just a side step, and then get your hip abduction when you come in. Side step or side lunge. Again, everything on that right side. Good. Let's grab that other weight. Oh, wait, I'm sorry. No, just doing the side lunge. We're not done with our sequence yet. So just the side lunge or just the step out and in. Okay, so just that step out and in or into that side lunge. We are not done with this yet. Then we got to add back a magic deduction for our combination. Then we can move back to our chair squat sequence. Good, let's get that last one in. Good, and now add back in. Hip abduction into your side lunge. You should be feeling that hip. Side step if the side lunge is too much. And then that straight leg out to the side once you come up. 10 more seconds in that combo. And then we go back to that chair squat sequence. I was trying to rush to get to. Right here, finish it out. Now we can grab that other knee. And we're gonna start with that chair squat, and then the movement with that wide squat is gonna go to the left, okay? So get those weights in position, shoulders down and back, feet together or close, and now we're right here. Keep that chest open as you sit down, and you press up. Seconds, and then we add that lateral movement out to that wide squat. One of each with that chair squat. Good, so get ready, we're gonna add it in. Chair squat, and then move and squat. Move and bring it in. Weight's coming back to the side. Move into that wide squat, bring it up, take it down and up. Good, you gotta move those weights out of the way as you step into your wide squat, both knees bending. Good, and now take it into that wide squat and you're staying in this position. Just that wide squat, and then we'll add back in that chair squat with a lateral movement through that wide squat. Right here, just holding that wide squat. To step in, feet together, lower down the other to that chair squat, step into that wide squat, and back in. Good, move through it the best that you can. And again, if you need to eliminate weights, take away the weights. Good, finish it up. And lose one of those weights. We are now taking it to the left side. Hip abduction, so get that nice strong stability in that right side. And take that left leg out to the side in. You're gonna feel that heart rate coming up. We're working those finger muscles today. And we're also pretty much nonstop through it. So that heart rate will tend to come up with some of these exercises. Good, we're adding in. Now remember that side lunge, or again, if you're not doing the side lunge, side step without that bend, step it in and back to your hip abduction. Just that side lunge or that side step right here. So now just stepping it out in, or again, stepping into that side lunge and pushing yourself back up and in, getting ready to add back that abduction. Push it up. Next 4 exercises, so our next 2 sequences that we're putting together. And this will be our last one standing. All right, so for the first one, I'm gonna grab both of my weights. You don't have to, you can hold on to one instead, okay? I'm gonna hold them up here, so you gotta have some upper body strength. If it's too much, just hold on to one in front of your chest. We're gonna take the legs out somewhat wide, and those toes are turned out as much as you can. We're gonna lift up both of those heels, coming up on the toes, and then we're gonna be adding in when we add into that Pulley squat with the heels down, okay? So we're gonna start with that calf raises first, toes turned out, so we wanna be like this, okay? We're gonna hold the weights up here the entire time. Only hold on to manage one, that's fine, okay? Get the legs out wide, get the toes turned out, and start lifting up onto those heels. I'm gonna tell you when that time has started in 2 and 1. You are in it in that time right now. You are focusing on getting those heels up, okay? And I'm gonna show you the next 2 exercises once we get to towards the end of this, okay? So as you're doing this, I will show you your next sequence that we're going to add in with this. 5 more seconds here. Just think about lifting those heels up best you can. Good. Now we're going to add in that Pulley squat. So you can drop down with the heels flat. Come up. Lift those toes. And then we'll do just that Pulley squat. And then we'll add back in those calf raises. So again, think strength. You don't have to work fast with this. You want to really think control through that movement. Good, now you're gonna go just the plie squat, which means your heels stay down the entire time. You don't lift up as you come up. And I want you to squeeze those inner thighs, squeeze those quads, those glutes, and those hamstrings, especially as you rise up. Direction those toes are in. Let's add back in that calf raise at the top right here. Lift to the toes, press the heels down as you come into that plie squat. So really sink those heels into that floor. Good. You guys stay right there. I'm going to start to show you the next move as you focus on that. We're going to come back into that chair squat position. But then once we're here, we're going to separate the feet a little bit and lift up one heel. Down and up from there so that we have one toe up. And then we're going to add on the little skate out in from that bend, okay? So whenever you drop one weight, get your feet together, but then separate a little bit and lift the right heel off the floor and now bend and extend from there. So see how I've got one foot flat, that's my left, and then I've got the right foot's heel is up. So I'm only on the ball of that foot. That's where I want you to be. You've got more weight right here. You're also gonna feel the engagement in that right leg, in that calf, also that quad that's kind of staying contracted in that position. And really think about digging that left heel into the floor, especially as you rise up. Now we're gonna add on that little skate out, just the right side here. Tap side in, you're still on that toe, and then press up from that left heel. Good, and then we'll hold just that skate, and then we will add back in that single or staggered stance squat from that kind of close range position here on the ball of that foot. Good. Now when you're ready, hold it down here. Just extend it out and in. You're going to feel fire in that left leg. If you need to bring yourself up a little bit, go ahead. If you manage to stay in that bent position and really force engagement through that left side, try to do so, okay? We're gonna add back in that up and down in 10 more seconds. Good, adding back in from that skate on the ball of that right foot, come on up. Left foot remains flat, and you're gonna feel that fierce power in that left side. Remember, you only have to do this side one time, then we move it over to the other side in that next set. Push up, good. stay on that right ball of the foot. You never come to the heel. You're staying on the toes on that right side the entire time. Good, finish it out. Come on up, and if you go into that secondary weight, those double calf raises, grab it. Legs are out and the toes are turned out. And we're lifting our calf raises from here. Turned out position. Breathe. Good, just that plie right here. Keep the feet flat now. You're not rising up on those toes. Good, feel that nice stretch in those inner thighs as you come down. Knees turned out, go in the same direction as those toes. Really trying to get those inner thighs here. Ready to add on, so when you come down, wherever you can hold, extend out, still on the ball of the foot, come up. You never bring that heel down. It's toes here, press up to that right side. Stay here wherever you can manage to hold and keep that super tight activated contraction in that right side as you skate out for the left. Super activated, guys. Hang in there. 10 seconds before we come up and down to add back in. Here we go, guys. Come on up. Lower down. Take it out and in. We get to release from that hold. Now, in between each one. But stay on the ball with that left foot. Of that hip thrust bridge.
through just those knees, and then you'll go back to adding on. Then we're gonna come to our side, and we're gonna do a side lying hip abduction. Get a little deeper into that hip now. When our leg is up, that's when our add-on is gonna come on. Bring the knee to the floor in front, push up to that ceiling, okay? And you add in your hip abduction. Just one time, then we'll stay there with just that knee pushed to the ceiling, and then add back in the hip abduction. And of course, you only have to do each side one time. So let's start here. Palms can be down, or they can be up. You can decide up is gonna give you a flatter back, but if you need a little bit of help with those palms down, you can do that. I'm gonna go palms up right here as I lift and lower and squeeze through my knees. I'm starting that clock now, so if you want to wait, you can. If you want to start already, you can get a few of them in, and we are on the clock right now, so go for it. Lift those hips up and down. Squeeze those glutes at the top with every lift. You guys got it. Get that hip thrust in. Lift up and lower that down. 20 seconds. Squeeze those glutes at the top. Remember, we want to think about activating, okay, those glutes, so make sure you're thinking about that. And now we're going to add on. So we come up, we come down, and that's where we drive those knees in. And then once the feet hit the floor, we lift back up into that bridge. And again, you can decide where you want those hands. If you prefer the palms down so you can press into the floor a little bit, you can. If you need to, make sure you're keeping that back nice and flat. Shoulders on the ground, you have those palms up. Either way is fine. Do what feels more comfortable to you. Good, now we're gonna stay right here. Just those heel taps and driving those knees in, land your knees bent. And if you wanna drive those hips up a little bit as those knees come in, you can. Make sure you're not rotating through that leg. You want to keep that inside of the foot parallel to the floor and really allow that hip to work. So if you're doing it correctly, you should feel it almost in the top part of that glute right here. Okay, almost like you're leading through the heel, not the toes. And you want to feel a nice pressure right here. You can get that top and side glute through that hip right here. Good, we're gonna add on. So once we're up, we're gonna tap the knee to the floor, push the heel to the ceiling, and then come down. Up, knee to the floor, lift, and down. So when you come up from that knee to the floor, it's like you wanna push that heel up to the ceiling, and then we lower down. Okay, so you can really start to feel that in that top glute. And remember, you only have to do one side one time. Okay, now we're gonna stay right here. Knee to the floor, push that heel up to the ceiling. Kick it up as high as you can on that angle up, and then we will add back in that hip abduction to finish off this side. Hang in there, feel that top glute, that hip right here. Dig into it, get deep, get it activated right here. 8 more seconds, we add back in that hip abduction. Good, let's go. Once you come up, lower down. You can really feel now that you have to make that bigger movement right there to come back down. You're gonna feel where it's activated. Lift, lower, come up, and tap that knee. Good, or palms up or palms down, and starting with that hip thrust right here in that group position. Feet flat, good. Those shoulders stay nice and flat on that floor as you come up. Squeeze those glutes to the top. Now as we come up and down, and then we bring the heels in, the knees into the chest, lifting the heels up to that floor, and then back into that bridge. Thank you. also had a little bit of that balance focus this week, so you can always go back to those to try to improve upon that. And the upper body, lower body strength, cardio and core, or you can get that hip mix that we did on Monday. So don't forget, you can save, share, or you can come back to this page, click on videos. All the videos are there for you anytime you want to do them and redo them, okay? And I will see you on Monday, so have a wonderful rest of your weekend. Hopefully you stay warm and cozy this weekend. And I will be back on Monday with a new week, new workouts. And I will see you then, guys. Have a wonderful rest of your day. Bye-bye.